Somebody texts Kristen and says, hey, do you know this girl, Faith Stowers? She stole my credit. She was out and stole my credit card. Like, I know because her friend came to me and admitted it. They were at the Roosevelt. And Kristen's like, yeah. And then Kristen goes, oh, my God. Wait. Hung up the phone. She goes, Stassi, I saw this article on, like, the Daily Mail or something. National. It was, like, national. A national news thing about a girl, a woman who stole, like, $300,000 worth of money and watches and stuff, like, drugged two dudes at a club in L.A., in West Hollywood or something. And she goes, let me just bring that up. It's like her intuition was just, like,
what?
Going nuts. And I go, Kristen, she brings up the article. I'm like, that is 100% Faith. Like, they had, like, video, like, footage stills of her walking in someplace. And so then I'm like, we have to be sure. So we, like, read every article. And it says she has tattoos on, her, like, the side of her body. Like, wherever she had tattoos, we, like, took a screenshot of what she was wearing. We start going through her Instagram. She deleted all of her photos on her Instagram. So then we went to her tagged photos. Mm. Stupid bitch didn't even think to fucking
hello
untag her tagged photos. So we go way back.
Amateur move.
All the tattoos match. We find a wig. She has a photo of the same wig that she had on because she likes her fucking wigs. Then we contact even James. I mean, this was like during filming. I think they were in Big Bear.
How is this not like more of a story?
Because because it's the law and all that. And like you couldn't.
Mm. Oh, so, okay.
Then James contacts somebody else who then calls Kristen and is like, that's my jacket that she stole. She's wearing my jacket. So we're like, we just solved a fucking crime. We're at Gracias Madre getting wasted and we solved a crime. We start calling the police.
Oh my God.
We start calling, yes, police don't give a fuck. First of all, it's really hard to like, I'm going to say this, like, it's very hard to actually get in touch with the police unless it's like an emergency.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We start calling the West Hollywood police.
Oh my God.
They don't care either. Finally, Kristen sees, this is like months later, sees when the police have not cared.
They're like, yeah, yeah, ladies, like continue your fucking snow cone margaritas, yes. Okay?
Kristen sees that she's at like Bootsy Bell. Is that still a place, Bootsy Bell?
I mean, you are asking the wrong
girl. I don't go to clubs, whatever. A club that's in West Hollywood. And Kristen's like, I'm going.
I love Kristen. Kristen. God bless her.
Goes, calls the West Hollywood police again and goes, I am where Faith Stowers is. And they're like, oh, we know Faith Stowers. Like, we know what she's done. Like, basically saying that we know, but we don't care to go and fucking find her.
Yeah, like we're good.
Yeah, like it was
$300,000
like,
worth of stuff.
A fucking lot. But she's like she steals shit. We all knew that, but we didn't know that she was like a hardcore, like she was homeless.
And she
during Vanderpump Rules, she was homeless, living on people's couches.
What about the couch that she got from Tom Sandoval? Didn't she pick up a couch from him? The details that I remember are really, really sad.
I remember that. I don't know where it went, but no one knows where she is now. Like Lala used to like plant things in her apartment to see if they'd go stolen.
No way.
Yeah.
What a crazy ass bitch.
And now she's on MTV.
Wow. You know, dreams do come true. It's a regular Cinderella story.
And sorry, but when she went in the military, she was, what's it called when you go AWOL?
Oh.
So I said, Kristen, fucking call the military police because they're looking for her too. Shout out, military police.
Did they handle it?
Faith Stowers. No, I'm doing this right now.
Oh, okay. Yes, listen, this is none a call of the, to action.
None of the police will get back to us.
This is like Serial right now.
It is.
You've really taken me on a journey that I did not know that we were going to enter.
Now I'm scared that
wow,
I'm saying this, that she's going to, because she has. So do you know that the night that this came out, the filming, when we were filming, the night that it came out at Sheena's birthday, that her and Jax hooked up.
Right.
Jax's car was stolen from his garage.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, no. When I woke up in the morning and someone said Jax's car was stolen, I was like, you can't make this. I don't know why that wasn't covered on Vanderpump Rules.
I mean, that's like, that's crazy.
Who gets their car stolen?
I swear to God, this show, Vanderpump Rules, takes me on such a serotonin, like, just, I'm on a roller coaster every time I watch it. I can't believe so much shit happens that so consistently.
Yes, yes.
Like, more happens in one episode of Vanderpump Rules than an entire season of The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. And it's like big shit.
Yes.
Like breakups and makeups and
I know.
It's so much stuff.
I know. But can I, before we continue with that, may I just say I have video cameras all in my house. So if Faith, if you're going to come after me or send your peeps,
don't even try.
Yeah. And everyone's going to know it's you because I'm announcing it right now.
Exactly. And by the way, I am excellent backup.
Yeah.
Just so, like, so you know.
Witnesses, like,
I would like to also say in my house I also have a security system, so don't fuck with me.
So yeah,
alarms and cameras.